And then the next part of this message is in Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 39. Let me read verse by verse and then explain that and apply that to us. Romans 8, 31 to 39. What then shall we say in response to these things? What's some of these things, if you look at the context, those are the sufferings of the present time. Those are the dangers. Those are the difficulties. Katotong mga apan, katotong mga pagsulay, katotong mga difficulties na i-go through, katotong mga uyok-uyok sa atong kinabuhi. Talks about groaning, talks about suffering, and other things. What shall we say in response to all of these so-called negative things? The Bible says, if God is for us, who can be against us? Whoa. Walay kaaway nga mas kusog sa Ginoo. Walay coronavirus nga mas gamhanan sa Ginoo. Bisan unsay ilabay nga bacteria nga virus sa imuha, if God is for you, no one can be against you. The Lord is saying that to you today. The Lord is saying that to you today. Lighthouse family, the Lord is saying to you, wala ka nag-inusara, ginaubanan ka sa Dios. Wala ka nag-inusara, kauban nimo ang Ginoo. Wala ka nag-inusara, the Lord is with you. He is your shield, your covering, and your protection. And then verse 32 tells us of a past action of God that gives us assurance that today He will continue to take care of us. Verse 32, He, that is God, who did not spare His own Son. This is when God gave up Jesus to die on Calvary for us, but gave Him up for us all, sacrificed Him. He gave Him to die for us. How will He not also, along with Him, graciously give us all things? All things. And this passage tells us, like us family, that yes, Jesus was sent by the Father as a big sacrifice for our spiritual salvation. And those of us who have repented of our sins and are trusting in Jesus are going to heaven. And yet the question is, how about on this life? Right now, from here up to the time we go to heaven, what happens? And the Bible says that God is for us, verse 31 and verse 32. It says that God gave us something in the passage, Jesus. And that is the proof that God will give us whatever we need. It is, in logic, a greater to lesser argument. In the natural, kung hatagan-tagani ka o 1 million, unsa na lang ng tig-gismil nga cellphone, siyempre pwede na ako na ihatag sa imuha. I've given you a proof of something greater, and now I am giving you the promise and assurance that I will give whatever. In fact, it says, graciously give us all things. This season, ayaw ka balaka. Kini nga panahon, ayaw ka hadlok. The Lord will provide for you. Basi nag-worry na ka. Basi morutan ning akong grocery. Basi unsa na lay may tawo mataknan ko halos dili na kabag mugunit sa bisan asa grabe na murag paranoid na kayo ka tanan si wash your hands 100 times a day or whatever. I don't know. But the point is God will give you all things. God will take care of you. Yeah. Amen. Then moving on, who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies or protects you, who declares you not guilty. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. What is interceding or intercession? It is prayer. Do you know that Jesus Christ sits at the right hand of the Father and is praying for you? He's asking the Father, Father, would you sustain them? Father, would you preserve them? Father God, would you keep them from evil? Father God, would you make sure they make it until the end? Father God, would you please cover them? The Son is interceding, praying, asking the Father for the Father's protection upon you. And the Bible says, whatever the Son asks, the Father gives. John 11, for example, Jesus said, I pray that you give me this, and I thank you that you always hear me. And so when the Father hears the Son asking, Father, protect my sons and daughters, protect my people, the Father will say, yes, my son, because He is so loved by the Father, and His prayers are always answered. Karon, yes, we pray for each other. Yes, we seek to cover one another in prayer. But do you know, someone is praying for you. Jesus is interceding for you. He's asking the Father, preserve them. Preserve them. Napa sila'y mission sa kinabuhi. Napa sila'y kinahanglan buhaton. Napa sila'y mga tao kinahanglan reach out. Napa sila'y kinahanglan nga maabot ng mga nasyon para madala sa imo. Please preserve them. Please preserve them. And I say to you, the Father is listening to the Son and say, yes, my Son. Yes, my Son. Yes, my Son. Amen and amen. And then it says, the word of God continues, verse 35, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Kinsa ang maka-separate? Unsa ang maka-bulag sa atoa sa gugma ni Kristo? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? Sword is a symbol of death. Kining mga trouble, hardship, famine, danger, sword, or death, baka bulag ba ni sa atoa sa gugma ni Kristo? And the Bible's answer is, of course not. Dili, walay butang na makabulag sa atoa sa gugma ni Kristo. And then the Bible says in verse 36, as it is written, naisulat sa pulang sa Diyos, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. Some of us are here, murag, in the back of our minds, natay kahadlok. Lord, basi nagahulat na lang yun ko na muabot na yun, na mamatay na yun ko, ma 6 feet below the ground na yun ko, marunan ko, sheep to be slaughtered. Maybe it's just a matter of time. Muabot yun siguro ni, maigo yun siguro ni, kay sa estime sa WHO, pwede man daw 75,000 ang ma-infect sa Pilipinas. Kunya, kung above 16 ako, taas ang magulang, ang rate na possible na mamatay ko. And so some of you may be above 65 and saying, God, what will happen to me? Lord, I'm like a sheep that's waiting to be slaughtered. But then the Bible says in verse 37, listen, verse 37, know in all these things, katunsa ng these things, trouble, hardship, persecution, famine, nakedness, danger, sword, or death, know in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him, that is Christ, who loved us. The Bible is saying, the Lord is saying to you today, Lighthouse family, everyone who's watching, those who are listening, in those troubles, in those dangers, in those difficulties, the Bible is saying that we are more than conquerors. Madaugon kita. Amen? Let me make that clear. We are victorious. Victorious means you will stay alive. You will stay healthy. The Lord will cover you. You will live through this trial. Amen? When this pandemic is over, you will still be standing healthy and strong, loving God and serving God. Amen? In all these things, we are more than conquerors through Christ because He loved us. You see, loved here is in a past tense. Now, it's very simple lang ni siya. Loved here is a past, what is that? It is the one act of Calvary. When Jesus Christ gave His life for you, the Bible says, by the wounds of Jesus, we are healed. By His stripes, we are healed. Do you know that when Jesus died for you, He shed His blood for you, that His blood washes away your sins. His blood breaks the curse. His blood paralyzes the power and cancels the power of the evil one upon your life. His blood heals you. His blood covers you. His blood protects you. And so in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. I want to speak to you, Lighthouse family. Ayaw ialaw ang yawa na puno ng imuutok og mga kahalok og mga bakak. Ayaw i-allow na inan kanya, basi anytime mamatay na ko, basi anytime matakdan na ko, basi kini na ang panahon na akong papa nga tigulan na, akong mama nga tigulan na, mamatay na gyud, basi kini na gyud ang magpatumba sa ako. Do not allow the devil to give you that lie. The Bible says, you are victorious. You are more than conqueror in Christ Jesus because He loved you through that act of Calvary, and He continues to love you, praying for you, taking care of you. And in verse 38, for I am convinced, and another word for convinced is sure or certain. In the English language, I'm convinced, pwede pa na iduda, but in the Greek language, the word convinced means sure or certain. For I am convinced that it's sure or certain that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor any Nothing else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Here or in the future, up there, down here, wherever, whatever happens, demons, angels, anything in this world, anything in the future world, anything in the physical creation, the Bible says that nothing can ever separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Lighthouse family, I want to encourage you today that the Lord loves you. He has loved you through Jesus. He continues to love you through Jesus. And today He's saying to you, I will take care of you. I will protect you. I will cover you. The blood of my Son who loved you is more than enough. It covers your sins. It protects you. It gives you that seal of protection. And nothing can penetrate that shield. The Bible says no weapon formed against us will prosper. And so today, I want you to believe that.